Okay, I am playing Battle Chess from the Easy Flash cart at double speed on my emulator because it really makes the animations extra smooth. So we'll just get right into it. Also makes the cursor a little jumpy, but we'll deal with that. Now, I was going to do a Queen's Gambit here, but it looks like he's already thwarted it. And the other thing is, I don't remember how to do a proper Queen's Gambit, so that is. This is the way the animation should play, though, if you ask me. It would be nice if this was what they their natural speed. Oh, it's like watching paint dry, isn't it? I don't care. I love Battle Chess, and I don't care who knows it. And as you can see here, we're playing on level novice. I mean, level one, sorry. Which has always, I've actually beaten level one before. I've beaten it on the computer, but usually I wind up making some boneheaded move, like that one was probably a boneheaded move, and, completely ruining my game. But the speed that it's running now, it feels like the speed that it was meant to run at. At which it was meant to run, I guess I should say. Do we have anyone who, you know what, let's, oops, jeez. Let's take our bishop. And get rid of his knight. Technically, the bishop is supposed to be a little bit better materially, but I will happily trade a bishop for the knight because the knights are insidious. Now the computer is going to be very bold in piece trading because it thinks it's up. It's got a material advantage, which I guess technically it does. But I play better when the computer's knights are off the table. He's already developed his queen. Which I guess I've given him no choice to do. He could have come out with that guy, but it would really remove a lot of protection from the king there. And he doesn't leave me a lot of options for that knight. So I guess I'll bring him out. Oh, that's really something. He's got my bishop. You know what? We'll just go ahead and take him off the table. Now the Amiga animations are much better, but I really find these to be very charming. Now we can threaten his queen or be taken by his bishop. We'll see what he decides to do here. Oh, he decides to take. Which is fine with me because that opens up this row for my rook, which is kind of half-heartedly threatening his bishop there. And I've got better pawn structure than he does. All mine are protected. So it looks like he's moving his rook out as well, and I've got no protection on that pawn if I move it up to threaten the queen. So let's. What can we do here? Let's do. Let's do that. What did he do? See, this is. He moved the queen there. Which, see. I think he's going to attack the king on this square here. This square. Both of his, but he has no backup for it right now, so. And the bishop is kind of stuck. In fact, the bishop is absolutely stuck, so let's move that. And maybe we can. Now he'll probably. Oh, interesting. Now I don't know why he didn't protect his bishop there. Puts him at a huge material disadvantage. Little naked guy. That's really interesting. Okay. Well, having done that, what is to stop me? What should I do? So the temptation here is to bring the rook up to that rank right there. Now I can't really immediately do it. He's got him protecting her. He's got him protecting that pawn. The king's got that pawn. But if he tries to threaten, I'm safe right there. And I guess the goal would be to set something up for this square here with either the bishop or the queen. Here's an idea. I don't know how good it is. We can move the queen there. And then move him here. Interesting. Okay, now let's see what we can do here. He's got the queen protecting him. I knew it wasn't going to be that easy. That just felt way too easy. If I bring her. Okay. Let's see if this works. I have no idea if this will work, but we'll see if he decides. Oh, he does decide to take. Interesting. Okay, so bring her there. Playing it at double speed like this really makes it efficient. Okay, now we can take this little guy. We can take this little guy and do pretty much nothing until that queen moves. All right, fine. You know what? We'll get him and put him here. I wonder if that's interesting. Okay. Oh, wait, she's a move away from checkmate. But if he comes down here, he would have to take, and then I would take with his queen, and he's got one move, he's got two moves away. I can bring my bishop up. Yeah, let's do that. Okay, I think I can checkmate him. So, now, if I can't, I'm screwed. He's just one move away from checkmate, but I think I have it. Think I'm screwed. Oh no, I'm absolutely not screwed. Okay. Oh, he's doing the block. Let's get him off this rank, shall we? I need him to move to a certain square. If his queen goes down to that first rank, it's all over. Except that I can block with my bishop. But he chose to block with a pawn, which means I can't get him. Well, it was fun while it lasted, I guess. Could I? Let's see where he goes. Okay. Do I need him to be in that square? I sort of need him to be in that square. I need him to. Okay, there. That does it. All right. That was a bad move on his part because now losing control here. It's going to go there. Now I can go here. And that may be checkmate. Yes. Oh, no. Okay. Is there no way to... This is a very convoluted checkmate here. And this is why I'm terrible at endgame. No, 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 no. Ah, fuck. See? I gave him that little opening he needed. All right, that was battle chess. Damn it, I screwed it up.